I mean, we're at the Royal Television Society Awards. You know, for me, I put this up there with the BAFTAs. I've been on the jury for the Royal Television Society Awards quite many times. So to have a show that I'm an EP on with Fraser Ayres and Minnie Ayres, it's a dream come true, because we were very intentional when we made this show. It was about filling the gap, you know. When you look at So Have I Got News For You and, you know, 10 Cats and all these other great shows, we didn't really see ourselves. And also we didn't see female captains. So we looked at these tropes and said, let's flip them. Let's have Chizzy Akadulu and Judy Love. Let's have them as team captains. Let's have me, in my version of my Stephen Fry, in the seat, because we've never had that. But also, let's show that Black history isn't trauma. Black history is about celebrating our inventors, our kings, our queens, and teaching everyone, no matter your age or your ethnicity, about the impact that we've had on the world.
And in terms of the impact of the show, has anyone spoken to you about what it's personally meant for them? For example, seeing female captains, seeing a black joy captured on screen?
Yes, loads of people. I was actually talking to Andy Peters, and I was like, we've been trying to get you. And he's like, listen, I want to do it. I want to be a part of it. And to have that conversation with someone like Andy Peters, which is somebody that represents black joy for me, you know, in terms of growing up and seeing what he was doing, that's what it's about. And also, you know, we've got some guests that we are dying to have on the show. And it isn't just about comedians. It's about personalities. It's about athletes. It's actors. It's entrepreneurs. And I think we're not a monolith. It's about showing that there's so many different versions of us, and we're trying to represent that within the show and through entertainment and education.
I mean, obviously, you've had some amazing participants already, but in terms of your dream guest, who would you love to have on, apart from Andy?
Ian Wright. I would love to have Ian Wright on the show straight away out of the bat. Also, I would love to have Moira Stewart. Also, I would love to have Stormzy, Lil Sims. And I would also love to have Lenny Henry. Come on. I think we've spoken this into existence, and we're going to make it happen.
I mean, I hope you are. I mean, if I don't. And I mean, obviously, looking in terms of what is happening the rest of the year and beyond, what are you most excited about?
I'm really excited about, I've just heard that season 3 of Bel-Air has been picked up. So I'm excited to start shooting that later this year. I'm excited also to see how my documentary is doing, Handle With Care, about fostering and adoption. And then also season 2 of The Towers coming out later this year on ITV and BritBox. So those things really excite me. And also, I'm not just an actor, I'm a producer, and there's some other projects that I'm trying to get off the ground. So for me, I'm just trying to be present right now. I'm surrounded here with friends and peers. I'm seeing Kano over there from East Ham. I'm from Plaistow, Canning Town. So Newham is in the house. And I'm just want to enjoy the night.
Just finally, you mentioned obviously Bel-Air, we're getting a season 3. What are you personally most hoping for in terms of where both your character goes and where the show as a whole takes us in that third season?
Yeah, for me, the third season, I'm really excited about getting into who Jeffrey is, where he's from, and like why he can't go back home to the UK.